I started writing music when I was about 12 years old. I had writers around me. My father was a musician. So it was kind of there. I was able to see how people crafted songs. And then somebody gave me a cassette tape of Stevie Wonder. And that really connected all the dots for me. That's where it all started. And then it was the trifecta of Stevie Wonder and the Beatles and then James Taylor. And that's really what got me into songwriting, because we were all saying the same thing over and over, but it's the way they said it that just made my brain think differently. New Orleans, I think it shaped my music in a couple different ways. I think just on a in a creative way, it's taught me to, you're always taught to respect the music and have a, you know, a certain level of integrity in the music. It's like, no, we're not just playing this. This is real musicians. The way that Ford and, you know, people grew up, their fathers worked in factories building cars, and then they went and built cars. Our factory in New Orleans is music. It's incredible to have Ford support my music. It's just such a brand that's so respected around the world. And to get little old me to link up with them, it's an honor. My new song, Sticking to My Guns, you know, it's kind of taken on different lives. Initially, I wrote it as a creative declaration that, you know, no matter what somebody wanted you to do, you were gonna be who you are and remain who you are in creativity. You know, it represents love, and that I want to stick to my guns as far as love is concerned, and combat any hate with love, you know what I mean, and be who I am, you know, because I think a lot of times when craziness happens, you're tempted to combat hate with hate, but I say I'm going to stick to my guns and just show love.